What can we do? How can the average Joe contribute to combating climate change? Hi everyone. If you're new to my channel, my name is Rachel and I share lecture style geoscience videos, but this video is going to be a little bit different. Today's topic is climate, but if you've been following me for a little bit, you know that I've already talked on my channel about what climate is, what controls climate feedback mechanisms, the greenhouse effect, how we know the carbon buildup in today's atmosphere is human caused. Spoiler alert, the answer is carbon isotopes. How little organic carbon that's produced actually becomes buried. Spoiler alert, it's a fraction of 1%, guys. The current Anthropocene climate trends and the ramifications of those climate trends in right now in the next few decades, and then also pretty much the entire Earth's history of climate and climate change through Earth's history, because I have a whole historical geology playlist here on my channel. But it's kind of crappy of me that I've only given you the bad news and I haven't given you a solution. And now you might be thinking, okay, Rachel, sure, you have a solution to climate change. Yeah, right. But hear me out. We regular folk that don't hold the key to major policy change often wonder what we can really do to make a difference. In fact, if you guys look in the descriptions of my videos on all the videos on my channel, you'll find a list of my favorite eco-friendly products, reusable straws, recycled backpacks, compostable trash bags, even bamboo toilet paper. But I've always wanted to directly contribute to carbon sequestration efforts. Haven't you? Well, I finally found a way. There's a company called Wren, W-R-E-N, and it's an amazing organization that funds carbon sequestration projects to fight climate change. Today, I'm going to be talking about how they do this, what kinds of projects they're funding, and why those projects work, just the science behind them, because my channel is about science and learning and all that. So let me start by showing you their website and what they allow you to do to help them in their fight against climate change. But before I do, I do want to specify that this is not a sponsored video. I just heard of Wren through listening to a science podcast, and I fell in love with the whole concept of Wren and what they're doing. And I know there's probably other organizations like this out there, but I hadn't thought to look for this. And when I found it, I was like, why haven't I done this before? So I hope that you guys feel the same way. And again, not sponsored, I just fell in love with this. So I'm gonna show you why I think it's so awesome and why everybody should take advantage of this opportunity, especially my audience. I know you guys are geo or earth lovers, just like I am. So let's learn a little bit more how we can help our earth and about the science behind these projects that they're funding. So if you head to their website, you can take their free carbon footprint quiz that will tell you exactly how much, how large your carbon footprint is. And as you can see, I've already taken it. So I'm just going to say continue because they know all my answers are ready. And I'm going to continue through this and show you my results at the end so you can see how much information they give you. So here now I'm at my carbon footprint page where they tell me what my carbon footprint is per year, which is 18.9 tons of CO2 per year that I contribute to producing, or I actually, you know, produce that much with my activities and what I do based on what I entered in the quiz. Actually, you don't even need to look at the results. Just by taking the quiz, it gives you so much information about what actually affects your carbon footprint. I mean, it asks you like what you eat, how much you travel, how much you drive your car every week, how many flights you take per year, all these things that make sense when you're doing the quiz, but like you don't think about all the time. And I'm not saying you have to think about them all the time, but I'll show you here what they tell you based on all that information you put in terms of your carbon footprint compared to other carbon footprints. For example, here they show you a graph of your carbon footprint compared to other household averages. This is based on country and also the world. And so mine is 19, which is based on, you know, I'm in the US. So based on other US households, it's pretty low. But compared to India, which I know a lot of my audience is from India. So hello, welcome. And you guys are doing much better than the US. And then, you know, the world average is 10, the UK is 26. So we've got all this range, and I'm sure I could look into the website more to find other countries that they have. But this is what they show you, and you can kind of compare yourself to other country averages. And then you can take a look if you scroll down to if everybody had your carbon footprint, we would warm the earth by 1.5 degrees Celsius within 5 years, which is really scary because as you saw on that graph, I have a higher carbon footprint than the world average, which is not good. And I am trying now to aim to reduce because I had no idea up until this point. And then if you look at this stuff that's like 19 tons of carbon dioxide, it tells you, okay, 52% of a humpback whale's weight is like my 19 tons of carbon dioxide, or almost 50,000 miles driven in a car, or 4 cows burping, or all these different things to amount to the carbon that I release annually. And then it shows you highest impact change, so what you can change to have the highest impact in reducing your carbon footprint. So I answered in the quiz, I do have a car that is a gas car, and I don't drive it that often. It has great gas mileage, but it does, you know, less good things than electric cars in terms of your carbon footprint. Then if you scroll down further, you can see your household's footprint by category. So I have a pet, I have obviously a home, my diet, my energy expenses, or how much energy I use or my household uses, my transportation, and my spending. Then if you scroll down, it says, see how much you can reduce your household's footprint. And it shows you by driving electric, which again, it said was my highest impact thing. You can reduce from 19 to 13 tons annually, which is great. And then there's also like avoiding beef if I press that. So it doesn't reduce it that much because I answered in my quiz, I don't eat red meat. So there's all these things that you can look at, and then it shows you even more information if you keep scrolling down. But what you can do is, well, if you haven't signed up, which I've already signed up, so mine doesn't say it, but it says, you know, do something about it, or it says like take action, and you press that button at the end of your quiz once it gives you this number, this carbon footprint, and all this information that it gives you for completely free, then it'll have that button. If you scroll down to the end, like take action, you press that and you can donate a set amount that they give you every month, which is like, I think it was like 25 and up. But you can also custom amount, which is what I did because I don't really want to start with $25 a month or higher because I, one, am a student and don't have that much money. And two, I just wanted to kind of get my feet wet and see how the program works, because once you sign up for monthly subscription and donating monthly, you get these emails with what projects you're funding, what the progress is on those projects. And I kind of wanted to join for a couple months and just see how those email updates worked, what kind of information they give me, and how the projects we're doing before I really, you know, dive in. So I customized my amount to $10 a month. You guys can custom to $1, $5, one penny. You can do whatever you want. You can even do one-time donations where you can offset a certain amount just one time. Like it gives you, oh, do you want to offset the past year of your life or your entire life? But it's just really cool. The customization is awesome. The information they give you is really cool. Honestly, paying $10 a month for emails with information about climate projects, like I would just pay for that. But they're also donating all of my money to those projects, to those efforts. So I just think that's really awesome. I'm going to stop rambling on and show you guys the projects that they're working on. So I go here to learn more in our projects. And if I click there, it shows all these projects. So they have 5 major projects that they're funding right now. The first one is biochar in California. This project, as you can see, they have little information paragraphs here, and you can even look at the whole entire like article basically they have about this project, but you can see a short version here. It says, this project helps prevent wildfires in California's old grown forests by removing dead and flammable trees. They then use a cutting edge process, which is basically they turn the tree biomass into biochar, or like this charcoal like substance that basically you just take the biomass, you put it in an oxygen free or low oxygen environment, you heat it up, and you create charcoal. The reason that this is a really important project that they're funding for carbon sequestration is because biomass, if it isn't turned into biochar or some other more permanent form of carbon rock type thing, then it will be degraded and be released into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide. But when they turn it into biochar, it is then sequestered and saved and stable in that biochar for thousands of years. But let's look at the next project. So the second project they're funding is community tree planting, which is a project that pays subsistence farmers in East Africa to plant trees and sequester carbon. Obviously, I don't have to really explain to you why planting trees is helpful in sequestering carbon, because trees photosynthesize, they take up carbon dioxide and release oxygen. But as much as I love planting trees and the idea of planting trees for carbon sequestration, it's not super permanent. And you guys know I'm a geologist, I'm a geoscientist. I like their third project because it is mineral weathering in Scotland. So mineral weathering is something I've talked about on my channel before in terms of its carbon sequestering capabilities. And if you guys have seen my first microbial weathering video, I talk in there about a lot of processes that have to do with mineral weathering, but also at the end, I go over why silicate mineral weathering is really helpful for combating climate change because of its carbon sequestration capabilities. So let me just play a quick clip from that video. Yes, planting trees is great, but plants obviously are pretty easily degraded upon their death. And, you know, all that work that they did to sequester carbon while they were living kind of goes undone once they die and are degraded and the carbon is then released back to the atmosphere. Burial of carbon through this process of silicate weathering and calcium carbon sequestration is really, really important for the more long-term carbon sequestration. And yes, there is an equal and opposite process like volcanism that releases that carbon back into the atmosphere. But if it's possible for us to tip the balance in the favor of more silicate weathering, it might be possible for us to contribute to a negative feedback regarding the current climate trend. And if you guys don't know what negative feedback means, let me just play a quick clip from my Anthropocene video. A negative feedback is something that balances out the current trend, whereas positive feedback mechanisms exacerbate the current trend. And positive feedbacks are what we're really worried about because we do not want to exacerbate any current trend. So we don't want positive feedbacks. That makes climate change too fast and nobody can adapt. Thank you, Rachel from the past. So with all that in mind, let's just take a quick look at this mineral weathering project that Wren is funding. So as we can see here, I clicked learn more and you can see this whole page here of information regarding this project. What I like about this project is they talk about how it works in bullet points, very easy to understand, and they talk about why this project. Let me start with how it works. So basically they spread basalt fragments, rock basalt fragments. If you guys don't know what basalt is, it's a type of igneous rock. I'm assuming if you watch this channel, you know what basalt is. But they spread these basalt fragments throughout the land. And as they weather, they increase the pH of the system and promote the formation of carbonates. Carbonates like calcium carbonate, for example, contain carbon and therefore act as a carbon sequestration mechanism that is sequestering the carbon not only into tree form or biomass or biochar, but into a rock form. And rock keeps the carbon and stores it for millions of years, not tens, not hundreds, not thousands, but millions and potentially even billions of years, which is really, really important for current climate change, because what we're actually doing when we, you know, use fossil fuels or whatever, we're taking the carbon that is in rock form from, you know, inside the earth, and we're just bringing it up to the surface, expediting what would normally be a millions of years process for that rock to then uplift and reach the surface. And we basically just subtract those millions of years. So if we can add rock back into the rock record that contains carbon, even if it's in the form of carbon, it's not necessarily organic carbon, that's fine. As long as we're sequestering the carbon, that's a really, really helpful and awesome type of carbon sequestration mechanism that this project is working on. And if you do go down to their why, they do talk about this. They say the permanence of this project is unmet by any other project. It sequesters the carbon for thousands of years. They say many thousands, but I'm telling you, millions of years, guys. It's rock. So that's why this project's my favorite. I know a lot of the funding right now for Wren is going into their tree planting projects, but I think this project is ultimately going to be the best. Now, I haven't fully figured out if you can pick which projects you're funding when you donate. I think you just fund all of them or whichever ones need it at the moment based on Wren's system that they have. I'll look into it and let you guys know. But the main thing I wanted to show you guys with this is that Wren knows what they're talking talking about. And they're giving us all the information that we need about these projects and their progress. I'm so excited to receive my first emails from Wren about what I'm funding and how it's working and their progress and all of that. I'm so, so excited. So I hope you guys are too. I know in some of my past climate videos, especially the Anthropocene video, I talk about positive feedback mechanisms that are occurring today, exacerbating the current climate trend. But in that video, I don't end it on that negative note. I actually end it by introducing the strongest potential negative feedback mechanism that will slow and potentially even stop the current warming trend. What is it, you ask? Well, let's check out this clip. What is really unique about this one instance of climate change over all the other climate change instances that have occurred throughout Earth's history is that humans have the brains to realize what's going on and to fix it. No other organism on Earth is able to do anything about climate change, let alone even realize that it's happening. So the fact that we have this knowledge and have the ability to do something about it can be a negative feedback if we decide to actually do something about it. So the only real question is, will we? And to answer my own question, yes, we will. How do I know? Because we already are, especially when organizations like Wren are making it so easy for the average Joe to pitch in. So I hope you're as excited as I am about this new opportunity I found, which for some of you, you might have been doing this with Wren or maybe even a different organization for a long time. This is the first I've heard of this. I probably should have looked into it way sooner, but this I'm just really excited about and I wanted to share it here so that my fellow Earth lovers could check it out. And I just signed up for Wren this month, and I've actually just started a Geo Girls group because I signed up with my Geo Girl Google account. So if you want to join my group on Wren, hello there, you can do so by going to the link in my description to see their website and then signing up. And if you want to join my group, that's great. I'd be so happy to connect with you guys there. And if you don't have the money to donate to Wren, trust me, I understand, because I know a lot of you watching are students, so don't worry about it. You can still click the link and check out their website and take the carbon footprint quiz to find out what yours is. Remember, that quiz is completely free, so go check that out. And you can also help fight climate change in so many other ways. It doesn't have to be through donating money. You can also donate your time, donate your efforts in changing your lifestyle, all of these different ways. And Wren will tell you ways that you can improve your carbon footprint that aren't just with money. So if you do go take that quiz, please down below, let me know what your carbon footprint is. I'd be so curious to know if you're comfortable with it. You don't have to share, but if you do, I'd be happy to know what yours is. I'm very curious now that I'm looking at all these things. You don't even have to tell me the number. You can tell me in, you know, cow burps if you want. You can tell me in flights annually. So whatever you want. I just think that whole program is so cool, how they tell you all the different information. So let me know in the comments below. And with that, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was a little different than my normal lecture style PowerPoint videos, but I really just got super excited about this opportunity and felt like I needed to share. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Come on, don't you want to save the planet? Don't you want to save the planet? No! Okay, you don't have to. You're just my, you know, extra little carbon footprint, aren't you?